Cincinnati, Ohio, home to the Hamilton County Justice Center. More than 50,000 people cycle through this jail every year.
To the left, right there.
Including an increasing number of women.
Okay. Don't get smart with Nobody's scaring you.
We're getting more female violators than we've ever had before.
The street life down there is like an addiction in itself.
We call her a jail celebrity because she's in here so much.
These individuals are ruthless.
This is like my third time. I ain't coming back.
They try to manipulate the system. They try to manipulate the officers.
And lie about who you were. And lie about having drugs.
We don't have any beds. Jail is full.
I just want help.
Anything can happen on any day.
Get off your hands and you'll be charged out again.
There's nothing that's going to make this better. Nothing.
If I get 10 years... I'm liable to kill myself.
I suggest y'all shut the f*** up right now. Right now.
The first stop for those arrested and charged with a crime is Hamilton County Justice Center's intake. Up to 100 inmates pass through these doors every day.
Just take our shoes and hand them to me.
After their identities are confirmed, they're strip searched, photographed, fingerprinted, and have their DNA registered. Then they wait.
Yeah, how long is it gonna take?
For bail, for trial, or for release.
Thank you, ma'am.
This Sunday night, Cincinnati PD arrived with an unruly prisoner in tow.
I'm here for what? For arguing with my and you bust my mouth, I got a lawsuit. You trying to be black, you must have got a white.
Stay against
the door. Don't tell me nothing.
Come on.
Man, you.
Police were called to Danielle's home after she and her girlfriend began arguing outside. Danielle was charged with disorderly conduct and resisting arrest, but she claims she was assaulted by the arresting officers.
All I did is have an argument with my girl, and that's all I did. And then they slammed me on the car, like, because I'm black. She, I don't know what the f- color she is, white, whatever. They slammed me on the car like I was a bad guy up in this nice polo, my Air Maxes, acting like I was the bad guy. How they don't know they ain't, she ain't beat me up. I already got a case with you. I already bust my sleep. Was arguing with my hoe.
I'm just arguing with my girl, like, so what? We supposed to argue, like, the world ain't perfect, like, that's not against the law, to argue with your companion.
This slammed me on the car and everything, and I'm finna get about, like, 100 racks off you. Thank you. Well, this lawsuit I'm finna hit.
She was accusing the officer of police brutality, you know, and she was very upset.
What's wrong with you physically?
Did my lip was bleeding? My polo was ruined.
Okay, so
I can
lip,
never wear it again.
Your lip your is your only problem right now, right?
Yeah.
It got busted. And let me see where it's busted.
Where you going up,
boy? Your lip.
You see?
Down.
Me slam on the car. Look at my polo.
I know, I see.
Yeah, nice polo.
I think she's more upset that her outfit was messed up.
$70. He acting like he down with the crackers. You came here to arrest me. Got me in jail, though. Little punk rookie right here was down with him. And I ain't being was arguing with my whore. We got a busted tire. And we was arguing. These crackers was arguing and called the police. They came and locked me up. Why didn't you lock the white hoe up? How the f- I'm a resistant. White. Leave me alone. Please tell him to not to put his.
Go in there.
There's other inmates out here. We have a job to do, and she was being very loud and, you know, using profanity. So I had to place her in the tank.
Like us. Y'all wanna be like us. You fight.
I work the search wall at least a couple times a week. We always have disrolees come in, kind of come accustomed to it. She wanted me to get upset, and a lot of inmates here want to see that. They want to be able to break down an officer and get the best of them sometimes, and you just can't let that happen to you.
Close beef.
Danielle is placed in a holding cell until her bail is set. Later that night, she was able to make bail and go home. Those who can't make their bail are held in the female housing unit until their next court date.
I'm just happy I got my envelopes and my colored pencils.
The unit is split into four different pods, and inmates are separated according to their medical needs and the seriousness of their charges.
My baby girl's gonna get so big without me being home. Oh my God.
Here in the jail, they're confined to their cells and in their pods. They don't have the freedom to roam around and do whatever they please.
6:30. At this time, the doors will be unlocked. You need to get up and push the doors all the way to the wall.
They're pretty much told when to get up, when to eat, when to go to bed.
But once a day, female inmates get a brief respite from the monotony of life inside their cells when they're allowed 1 hour of recreation on the jail's rooftop deck.
Miss Jones, you wanna walk with me? I'm getting fat in here.
Baca has been incarcerated here for almost 2 months, awaiting trial on a felony charge of assault. She is 7 months pregnant and will likely deliver before her trial.
What I'm in here for, I didn't really do. But even though that you didn't do a crime, you could still be found guilty of a crime. It's overwhelming when you come in here, especially having to learn all the new rules and the people and knowing that you're basically, your freedom has been taken from you. That I'm not getting the nutrition I need, I'm not getting the rest I need, because even though I'm pregnant, I'm not gonna get special care. It stinks up here. Maybe it's just me, I don't know. You really don't understand jail until you live it. Once you actually live it, you're like, oh, it's a living hell.
You gotta get the job done.
Being pregnant and being in jail is not the way to go about it. If I could rewind to where I was either after I had my baby or not even be pregnant at all, I would do that. Because being pregnant and in jail is torture. It's going to be really hard because I'm going to be probably like the next 10 weeks delivering. And I'm going to have to get rid of my auntie.
Stressful. Thank you, officer.
Thank you.
It's Monday morning, and First Shift Command Sergeant Moore escorts Amber, who has been brought to the jail on drug-related charges.
Straight all the way down the hallway.
I've been in this jail about 5 times. I was here with a burglary, just felony too, that I beat. I've been in Claremont County Jail for all kinds of drug charges. I've been in theft charges. I've been in Warren County Jail. And I've been in and out of jail since I was young. I was in juvenile too.
How long have you been using drugs?
Since I was 14.
6.5 years.
Since you were 14, who got you started using drugs?
Everybody.
You just started smoking weed?
Started out drinking, I started smoking weed, started popping pills.
At 14, yeah. You were popping pills?
14, I was shooting dope.
Who taught you how to shoot dope?
My friend, her boyfriend. They were like, I was like, I passed dare, you know? I was like, I'm never gonna shoot heroin. It's like, come on, it'll be worth it. I'm like, nah, I was like, I don't want that. Cause I didn't want to get dope sick or whatever.
And how old was she at the time?
She's my age.
She was 14. Shooting dope, shooting heroin?
Her boyfriend was doing it with her.
How old's the boyfriend?
It's 4 years older than us, so he'd have been 18.
Always an older male around somewhere.
I mean, I don't blame it on him, though. I mean, I did it to myself, you know.
But at 14, yes. Did you know any better not to shoot dope?
No, but I said yes, you know.
And how was that first high?
Like, nothing mattered anymore.
Nothing mattered.
Everything I do kind of revolves around my drugs.
Amber is put into a holding cell while her bail is determined.
My mom and my ex-fiance both died of a heroin overdose. I just kind of like spiraled into a depression, you know what I mean? I have died once. This Christmas Day, I wanted to die. I wanted to die. I was so fed up with hurting people. I was so fed up with doing things wrong. I was done. I ate a bunch of Klonopin, which are a benzodiazepine. It's a deadly mix when mixed with opiates. I flatlined, I was dead, completely dead. I woke up in the hospital. I was like, are you kidding me? I was mad. I was mad a lot. I got home. I went to my grandma, said I died. She's like, I know.
Though Amber's bail is set at only $400, she is unable to come up with the money, so Sergeant Moore will escort her upstairs to the female housing unit.
Nobody has $400?
My grandma's got it, but, you know, I don't really expect her to do that, you know? That'd be kind of mean, wouldn't it?
Is Grandma able to come down and post your bond?
No, that's another thing. She's not able to get out and do it, you know?
Just have a seat right here. You know why you're up here, right?
Tell me.
Because you can't come up with that $400 and you have no place to go on EMU. So you're going to be in jail.
Oh, yeah.
Until we figure out your next court date.
Wonderful.
So I'm going to change you out, take your clothing from you. You're going to step over there, get a bedroll, hygiene items, new uniform, and then we'll get you classified so you can go upstairs to population, okay?
I think I'm going to turn my life around. I've been screwing up for so long. It's about time. My grandma's real sick right now. My grandma's my life. So I'm really trying to get back to her.
Make another left. Straight down the hallway. Stay to the right-hand side for me, please.
I can do anything I set my mind to. So if I want to get clean, I know I can get clean. It's all in my mind. You know what I'm saying? It's all in here. I hate this color orange.
Going in the door to the right, and you're going in D-pod. And we don't have any beds. Jail is full. Right now, we're extremely overcrowded, and we have 16 floaters, which means we had 16 females that did not have beds. They were just hanging out in the pod.
Where do I set my stuff at?
In the back.
In the corner?
Open D, please.
Do I sleep on the floor?
Until they find you a cell.
And you just let me go.
You'll get your turn.
Everybody's staring at me. I hate that shit. I'm about to go in here.
Good luck.
Yep. I'm irritated as It's irritating. You don't know that. I have to focus on good things. I have to focus on stuff that I need to do, not focus on stuff that's not good for me.
Amber was released later that day due to overcrowding. She has since been arrested twice for drug-related charges. The jail separates inmates according to the seriousness of their charges.
Yeah, put the Kool-Aid on your lips, like lipstick.
Female inmates with maximum security classifications are placed in C-Pod, which has earned it the nickname Murder Pod.
Y'all didn't even do the book.
But during the long days here, inmates focus on more harmless pursuits.
Not that you're supposed to do it every hand.
I wonder what's for lunch.
I don't have place space, and I know
lunch.
That nasty ass food.
Keys.
They used to sell playing cards on commissary. They were using the playing cards to jimmy their locks. So when the door was shut, it appeared to be locked, but it was not. That's a security risk. So they took the cards off of commissary.
I'll try the commissary period, baby.
I ain't making no break.
They need a new bed.
Now, they'll take milk cartons and cut the milk cartons up to make playing cards. But if we find them, we take them and throw them away.
I'm just saying, though. What's up, though, bro? What y'all doing, bro? What y'all doing, though, bro? I mean, what's shaking? What's good? What's poppin'? Y'all some Jolly Rancher, bro?
Tiana has been held at the jail for the past month. following the death of a local high school student. She is accused of murder, but claims the shooting was an accident.
We were all in the car together. I let my one friend drive my car. My other friend was in the front. I was in the back. I was about to hand him the gun, and the gun went off and hit him in the back of the neck. He died 3 days later in the hospital. And I'm in here.
Y'all think I'm playing? I got all the aces.
You know, beat up over bags and chips and I made the most up decision in my life. You know, this boy has so much going for him. Princeton football player. College is one of them to play football. I had a kid on the way, and I just feel like I snatched all of that, making the dumbest decision in the world. I know his family probably hate my guts, and I mean, that's okay. Because at the end of the day, that was their baby. Nachi's no nothing. You ain't getting this feedback, bro. Honestly, no one has treated me like I'm murder. I mean, it's apparent to even the people on my pod that was an accident. Like, they tell me all the time, you ain't a killer. They'd be like, oh, you'll beat somebody else, which is for sure. But to just take a life, that's not me. So no one's treated me like that. And actually, I'm grateful. This is where I lay my head. This is my desk. I was in the process of writing a letter to my aunt. This the sink in the toilet. This is jail, so it's together, you know. These lights be beaming all nighttime. They don't turn them off. This is Mikasa, I guess, you know? And this house is when I first got in here, I went to sleep, I was cool, and woke up and just the reality smacked me in the face and I just broke down and started crying. As you can see, I ain't got no bunkie. I'm not allowed to have one. My charges, which is murder, you have to be in a room by yourself. Bunking alone is no fun. Sometimes it's an advantage, but sometimes it's a disadvantage. Because when you're in here for so long, like on Saturdays, we have what you call bleach day. Bleach day is when you in your room till 3 o'clock and they bleaching the whole pod. So I have to be in here. And when I'm in here, I'm reading this, the New Testament, what would Jesus do? Because these walls, if you're not strong for real, like if you're really not mentally strong to be in here by yourself, these walls begin to close in on you. They will close in on you. Like it's lonely. I ain't gonna lie. It's bad. And then I look at my pictures, it just keep my head on straight to let me know what I got on the outside. Cause without that, I'ma just be in a chair, strapped down, getting the Thorazine shot in the ass. Yeah. All of this is my stomping ground, but this will be the last of it that I see. I used to be the person walking past the Justice Center or something, you know? And now I'm actually in here. It's reality. Like if my girlfriend come visit me, she'll park down there somewhere and then she'll stop right there at this corner and wave at me, give me little hearts and stuff and tell me she loved me. And it's just so much running through my head. What's gonna happen to my girlfriend? How she gonna feel about it? If my son will even remember me? My son will be 3 September 3rd. I might not even see my son until he's 13. That's if I get 10 years. The dumb decision that I made, a life is gone. I don't my son's life. I don't my life. I don't my girl life. That's it, you know? It's sad, but this is what it is. This is the harsh reality of being in jail.
As night falls on Cincinnati, Hamilton County's intake department fills with people from all walks of life.
Swallowing street drugs within the past 24 hours.
Just sit here, step up here. Together.
27-year-old Jamie says she was arrested while trying to enter her own apartment, but police see it differently.
She was arrested for breaking and entering. She broke into an apartment building without permission of the owner or the owner of the apartment building. She used a hammer to break the lock and was arrested.
Basically, I beat down the door with a hammer, but I got permission from everybody along the way. It's not like I just, you know, ran in there, and I kind of did, but that's why I'm here.
Normally, when they come the first time, they're crying. She was laughing, carrying on. Sorry, Mom. Could be drugs. just depends on the person.
Number of years you completed in school?
27. All my pretty much self-taught degrees.
Single, married, separated, divorced?
Okay, Pa.
Scars or other marks?
Scars, handcuff marks, bruises, tattoos. Yep.
Just the one tattoo on your side?
No. Yeah. That one, and then one of my feet, and I can't show the rest.
Okay, have a seat. The nurse will call you after you talk to the nurse. You can make a phone call.
I basically freaking have been up since two nights ago because I've just been determined, because I've been busting my ass my whole life to get where I'm at. And I collected all this and basically moved it from moving on up to the east side. That's what I call it.
After being searched and turning over her possessions, Jamie meets with a staff nurse for a routine physical. Although the jail does not test for drugs, pregnancy tests are routine for any inmate suspected of being under the influence.
I am like, not anything else. Everybody's like, my family, everybody, they've been looking at me, they've been wondering, but they know all my ancestors, and they know all the people that make me me, and always, everybody's always told me just to be me. After all these things I've added up from the time I was a baby, and wanted to do something that I've always wanted to do, which is try to save the world, because my parents have always told me I can do whatever I want, and that's what I want to do, so. I've been spreading this around and give the world a gentle reminder, a smile, and I couldn't think of a better way to solve the economy than making everybody just come together and party out. I tried to drink a bottle of wine, which got already drank in the interrogation room, which was funny. But basically, I drank like that much wine like in the last 2 days, and I've had like 2 or 3 hours of sleep.
They're under the influence of some sort of chemical, then basically you're just going to keep an eye on them. She's probably going to spend the night and go to court in the morning.
Life on the inside isn't always lonely for accused murderer Tiana. Today, a jailhouse haircut gives her a chance to spend some time with her girlfriend, Nunu.
Why is
he still?
Oh my God, you're gonna break my neck, bro.
You so dramatic, go ahead.
You dramatic. So should I do?
Should you? Oh my God, if you don't be still, you're gonna have a bald spot.
I'm about to snap, bro.
Snap all you want.
You see what I deal with?
I ain't
this is what I deal with.
I love women, I'm a femininity chaser.
Man, I don't like her, bro. Yeah. Man,
do you say you flirt?
Look at she be flirting. Do you see? But do you see that?
You a flirt too,
man. But I ain't not like
don't
that.
You be still.
No, man, cause you pissing me off. You love me, but you give me a bounce spot.
We know what shift to do it on, what shit not to do it on. Pretty much, first shift is the best shift. If they in the booth and they ain't paying attention, we slide up in the room and do what we do and come out happy as hell, like.
Jail policy forbids inmate relationships and punishes them with the same rules that apply to fighting. If Tiana was caught physically displaying affection, she and her girlfriend would be put on 23-hour lockdown.
I'm attracted to her because, I mean, she's real.
Set her ass.
No,
tie your ass.
She just real and she don't give a like, she just, like, to be honest, we was gonna beat some up on Tuesday.
We ain't got time for that.
I attract nothing but crazy girls, because I'm crazy. I'm not, yeah, I'm crazy.
What?
Huh? It's like magnets.
Shut up, Teeth.
It's lunchtime in Murder Pod, and with over 50 females packed into the unit, tensions always run high. 7 months pregnant and awaiting trial on a charge of assault, Baca's stress boils over when she believes her bunkie has been gossiping behind her back.
I'm gonna come to 20 years, come get my everybody in here. I'm sick of everybody in here running their mouth. I'm already on this before y'all even left. Flat out. Don't let the excuse me. Don't let the excuse me. I'm pregnant because my face, my hands ain't pregnant. Flat out. Don't even switch now.
Sherry, when Sherry was here, she came to me and said that you told everybody in the pod that I
read your indictment.
Really? That's not what Sherry said. On top of that, you're going to sit there and tell Shay you don't talk about her? You a dope thing, crackhead, and anyway, you, you still talk. You still call.
That's all I said to Shay, Shay.
So you ain't a boy.
You say you talk about every I sit there and do nothing, really.
You said last night.
Wow.
Yeah,
Shay is loud.
Exactly.
And that's all I said about Shay. Everybody over here and everybody over there. So don't say, really.
I talk about everybody.
You talk about everybody, Baca.
Put a name on it.
Really.
Put a name on it.
You sit there and you talk about. Hit me. Hit me. Hit me. Hit me.
Back in maximum security C-pod, 7 months pregnant and frustrated Baca has reached a boiling point with her cellmate. To quickly gain control of the unit, deputies place the pod on lockdown and order all inmates into their cells.
Close the doors, ladies.
She come out stating that I was talking about everybody, and next thing I know, she started pushing me. I'm really upset because this is jail. I'm probably gonna be put in a hole now. So yeah, I'm pissed.
I'm gonna listen to God. They can lock me in here. I don't care.
If you don't care, come on, let's go.
Because you know what? Can't nobody take my freedom from me. If you lock me in here, if you lock me up anywhere and throw away the key, I'm always going to get freedom regardless. Can't nobody take my freedom from me. Do you think this is the face that gives a f- about any of these in here that don't care about me, my family, my kids? They don't give a f-. That's why they in here. That's why they in here. Flat out.
Hey, is cell four still open?
I think so.
Okay, we're going to move Baca to cell four.
Hey, Baca. All right.
Baca grabbed that mat
because they were roommates. We obviously had to separate them. Bridget was being the aggressor. That's why she was the one chosen to move.
I'm not here to make friends. You can't make friends with criminals.
Tiana, get away from that door.
Baca will receive a disciplinary hearing before she is sanctioned for the fight.
You pregnant and you fighting, man? For real, that's what you do, Baca?
It wasn't even a fair fight because I've already jumped in. I'm the only in there that's got enough balls to put my hands on anybody. Because I'm not scared of nobody. I'm not scared of nothing. Lions, tigers, and bears, I'm not scared.
Until then, she'll be locked down in her cell 23 hours a day and only let out when there are no other inmates around.
Jamie.
Yeah.
What's going on? Can you wake up for me?
Yesterday, Jamie was arrested for breaking and entering. Jail staff suspected she was under the influence of drugs. She was admitted to the housing unit and has now been asleep for 17 hours.
Wake up. You know you missed court today? It's common for people to come in off the street and crash for 48 hours because they've been up sometimes for a week, selling their bodies, using drugs, doing whatever they have to do to get those drugs. So when they get here, they are extremely tired and they crash. Sit up for me, Jamie.
Oh God.
What's going on? Are you okay?
I am now.
All right. They tried to wake you up all morning and you wouldn't get up. What?
Farewell, I've had enough of me.
I need you to say it for me one more time, English. What'd you say?
Farewell, I've had enough of me.
They were laughing at you.
Farewell.
Earlier?
If Jamie sleeps for more than 48 hours, she'll be placed under medical supervision. Until she wakes up, her court date can't be rescheduled.
Did you take something that made you so sleepy?
No. They tried again to feed her, still again, no response from Jamie. And as you see, she's just really, really tired. So whatever she's been outside doing on the streets is taking a real big toll on her. You still sleepy? You want to go back to sleep? Okay, going back to sleep.
Jamie slept for 23 hours straight. When she woke up, she was released on her own recognizance. Down in intake, 20-year-old Destiny faces a charge of robbery for allegedly attempting to steal a woman's purse.
They're telling me that I stole some lady's purse and I beat the out of her and she's in the hospital and I didn't do none of that. For real, to look at my hands. If I put this girl in the hospital, you don't think I'd be having cuts all over my hands? All I remember, I was in the car with two of my dudes. He thought it was a one way. It wasn't. The lady was going left. We T-boned her right in the middle. Apparently, from where I wrecked at, the robbery was happening like a couple streets away. At the same time, I was in a wreck. So how am I gonna rob this girl if I was just in a wreck? This is from the car wreck, and they're trying to blame this on the girl fighting me back. Like, I don't even know what girl they're talking about. Do I look like I would even wear a purse? I've never seen this girl. They didn't find nothing on me. They're gonna try and say that I robbed her and I was trying to get away and I wrecked in the meantime. And that's bull, man. They're saying they got witnesses that seen this. How can they go on witnesses when they can't prove nothing? I'm sitting here for nothing without my baby boy. He's 4 and he's my world. And I know he's wondering where I'm at right now. And for him to think that I did something like that to somebody, breaking my heart, man, this ain't right. I'm a damn good mom. I died for my kid. If I could change anything about what happened, I would change that I made sure I never left my son's side. I can't even explain what I feel right now. Only thing I could do is sit here and cry and pray to God that he lets me out. That's all I got.
Destiny made bail 4 days later and was released pending her next court date. It's a typical weekday afternoon at the Hamilton County Justice Center, and the jail's intake is filled with individuals charged with all manner of crimes.
Now, been what?
I've been here since like 1.
It's 2 o'clock, so it's been a while now.
We all been here too long.
53-year-old Cheryl says she doesn't know why she's in jail. She was arrested a few hours ago on a felony warrant that dates back to 1998.
Today I was at a corporate picnic with my mom and my two little nephews, and the law pulls us over and he says, step out of the car. I said, why? What have I done? He goes, you've got a felony warrant on you. And I said, I've got a what? And I couldn't understand what it was for. I had my two little nephews with me and they seen this, and it wasn't good. 30 years ago, I stayed in here for 2 days.
See, look, her case is from when?
1998, and I was here in 1986, too. I used to be pretty rowdy in my day. Thieving was my thing, to get my drugs, and it wasn't fun. I did my time, and I thought I was done. My family was getting to the point where it was like, oh, God, here she comes. Wonder what she's going to be on the day.
Willock. Armand. Busby.
And I went down to Kentucky and got me a job and took my car down there, didn't know nobody. And I decided to just go clean and get everything straightened up.
Cheryl, what's your birthday?
9/25/58. It was all me, and it wasn't a picnic.
Mom,
All right, ma'am, I need initials on these red lines and a signature at the bottom.
I could only beat myself up for so many years. I'm not proud of what I did, but I get by every day, and I do a lot better, and I believe in my God and my family, and we get along great now.
I'm calling Mel Ryan. I'm passing metal detectors.
Thank you. Oh, yeah, there's my mom. Okay. This warrant's an old warrant. I don't know what's going on, and I have to go to court tomorrow to find out. I'm hoping this is a great big mistake. Hoping that it is. I pray it is.
Cheryl has not returned to the jail since her release. In the jail's upstairs housing unit, Baca has been moved to lockdown after a fight with her cellmate.
My aunt and my daughter are supposed to come down, but I think she's at work, so hopefully they'll come down, and if not, then... That's fine, my aunt now.
Once she receives her disciplinary hearing, she may lose privileges, such as visitation and commissary. But for now, she's still allowed to take a visit with her 2-year-old daughter.
Mommy. It was a blessing I got to see my daughter before I got locked in.
Tell mommy you love her. Say, don't cry. Stop crying.
Tell
you
mommy, good?
Say, stop crying.
You been good? You have to have a lot of patience in here because otherwise, you're gonna go crazy. This is like the hardest time. It's being in county jail.
I want to see my daughter, so I want you guys to bring her, but it hurts that I can't get to my daughter from here.
Yeah, but she want to see you too, and it hurt her too. And it's going to continuously hurt until you get out.
Mommy!
Keep swimming, because this little love you.
Why would I come home to a kid that's not going to know me?
She ain't going to know you.
Mommy's
not going to know me like she know me. She's not gonna know me like Monique know me. She's not gonna know me like that. She's gonna have to live life through a prison if that's where I go. I don't want my kids drug through that, but I don't have no choice. It makes it really hard that I know that I have a daughter that I don't even get to see.
Talk to mommy.
You've been big and come down here to see your mommy all the time. You gotta say something, punk.
I feel distant enough like this, and then she don't even want to talk to me when she comes down here. I don't want to cry because she thinks I'm in here because of her already. So she thinks she's a bad girl.
Mommy, don't cry.
She's 10 times Bridget.
Tell mommy don't cry.
Don't cry.
She just doesn't understand why I'm here exactly. She thinks it's her fault. I told her that you're a good girl and I'm not in here because of you. But she doesn't fully understand. She's only 2 and a half, so I can't even be mad. I've been here 46 days, 2 months. This is my first time ever being in jail, so I'm not used to
somebody
just snatching my freedom from me.
Put your hand up there. Catch that hand. Get it.
I hate when she's like so close and I can't even touch her. I love you.
I love you.
I'll see you later, okay? I want you to be good. Okay? Mwah.
Give me a hand.
I love you. Be good, okay?
Baca gave birth to a healthy baby girl and plans to give custody to her aunt so that her baby will be raised with her sister. Baca is still in jail awaiting the resolution of her charges. Oh, It's Thursday night, and for the men and women of the Hamilton County Justice Center, a routine day at work.
You write them up there.
Well, you can do it, okay. Even better.
Back in, take a walk with me.
But for this 24-year-old mother, the night is anything but routine. Kristen was arrested after she used mace on her neighbor. She claims she was defending her family.
A woman attacked me yesterday with me and my child, and then tried to again today. She went to jail for the assaulting of me and my child. She just got out today, and when she got out, she came straight to my home, tried to assault me again. As I was standing there talking to my children's father, she snatched me by my hair down. And I had my mace in my pocket, and I pulled it out and sprayed it everywhere.
For all the street jerks?
I had to protect my children. I don't like fighting in front of them. I'm a role model for my children. My skin's burning. I have itching.
Did you take off all your jewelry?
I don't even know this woman. I just moved into where I'm at, and they said pretty much she just goes around starting trouble with everybody. I called 911 first, and they proceeded to go to her house, listen to everyone that was down there, what they had to say, nothing of what we had to say, and said that they just feel like it's going back and forth, that she went to jail last night, so it's my turn. They said that I maced her, that's why she attacked me. I did not know that mace was not legal until tonight. I thought you could carry it for protection at any time, especially with children. I mean, you have to protect yourself and your children somehow.
In Ohio, mace is legal, but in the way that she used it, caused physical harm to someone else. That's what caused her to get charged with assault.
How many years of school have you completed?
12.
Single, married, divorced, separate?
Single.
Are you working?
No. I'm a stay-at-home mom.
Any scars, marks, or tattoos?
I have a tattoo on the back of my neck.
Look it up.
My daughter's name.
You're eligible to go home because we do not have room for males or females with nonviolent charges. Since your charge is eligible, you have to wait to talk to pretrial. As long as you don't have any violent felony convictions in the past 5 years, he'll give you a court date to come back to court tomorrow morning. 9 o'clock, room A in the Justice Center. Did you want to make a phone call?
Yeah.
All right.
I felt like what I was doing was, you know, better than fighting back. Huh? Hello? Hello? Will you please, down Justice Center? Yeah. They're getting ready to let me out. They aren't supposed to be on its way, sitting out here, picking me up. I'm actually gonna get a protection order on Monday. And so I'm hoping to keep my distance throughout the weekend and Monday morning be downtown first thing and get a protection order. I wouldn't have done anything differently.
Kristen was released the next day on her own recognizance.
You ever been here before, ma'am?
It's 7 p.m. An emergency call goes out to all deputies. An officer-inmate fight has broken out in the female housing unit.
I'm a TV time, but I've been keeping my cool here, bro. I swear I've been keeping my cool, bro. I've been so cool since I've been here, and it ain't me.
Jail life has proven too much for Tiana, who is facing a life sentence for murder. Minutes ago, Tiana and another inmate began arguing. When officers intervened, she turned her anger against them.
She became so irate and out of control that we had to place her into our restraint chair.
It ain't me. Most of them holes are big, got bedded, bro.
It took 6 men to get her down.
It's nothing that's gonna make this better. Nothing. It's hard, man. It's hard, man.
You know what I expect from you? I expect you, the intelligent young lady that you are, to make better choices knowing your situation. But I want you to continue to make better choices and not put yourself in these predicaments. You took something that went from a small argument to you being in a restraint chair.
Over here, I'm not crazy for one.
Right.
I'm not crazy.
You popped on the wrong people. You can't do that with the officers. You can't.
Let her make it better. I mean, kill that but I killed that. I put money on that.
Man, get the out of here, man.
Don't shy, man. I'm cool.
Tiana refuses to calm down. Medical staff decide to give her a tranquilizer.
I don't need no shy, man.
Okay.
Calm down. Breathe, because you're not breathing right now. I need you to breathe. I know you're angry, and I know you hurt, but you're going to have to calm down. Didn't I tell you this was going to happen? Didn't I tell you that?
I've been here for a month, and I've been keeping my mouth closed. What do y'all expect?
Quit on your breath and breathe.
I'll just wait to get your blood pressure in a minute when you calm down, okay?
What did you just tell me? That you was going to be cool?
I tried. I ain't being nice no more, so y'all better expect a lot of this, bro, because I'm about to start fooling.
Okay.
I'm fooling, bro.
Okay.
Finally, Tiana relaxes enough for medical staff to administer an oral sedative and allow her to be released from the restraint chair.
Certified to punch people.
Go lay down. Come on.
I can't do 10 years. I can't. If I get 10 years. I'm liable to kill myself.
Tiana remains locked up, awaiting the resolution of her charges.